Hey guys! So I got a few comments lately about the new Arbar from Instruo and how it is compared to the Morphogene from Make Noise, and I really think that they are two totally different modules and should not be looked at as having the one or the other. So today we will look at how they are similar and mostly at how they are different, and hopefully by the end of this video you will get to the conclusion that you need to have both of them. So first of all, let's look at the ways we can record to the Morphogene and to the Arbar. The Morphogene has a stereo input, but you can also record in mono. And we have a few input gain settings since the last firmware update, so we can set the levels of the incoming signal. You just have to hold record and hit shift. And here you can see the colors are changing, which indicates the different input gain settings. And we can record up to almost 3 minutes of audio in one recording, what's called a reel. And there is also a micro SD card, so we can store multiple recordings or reels and have different sounds available to us. Now the Arbar has a mono input with a dedicated gain control, but we also have a built-in mic, so we can use this also for recording live, for example. And there's also a really nice feature that we can set the sensitivity of the recording, so the Arbar will start recording by itself whenever a certain threshold is passed. We have 6 buffers we can choose from, and on each buffer we can record up to 10 seconds, so we have 60 seconds all in all. And the Arbar has also an SD card, but for now there is still no manual, so I'm not so sure how it will work with transferring files onto it. But already just by looking at how the recording process works on the Morphogene and on the Arbar, we can see that there are different types of modules with different uses also. So the Morphogene is more of a tape machine / sampler, and the Arbar is more of a granular processor. And I have already a short piano loop recorded to both modules. This is the one on the Morphogene. And you can hear that it plays the sample from the beginning until the end. And this is how it sounds like on Arbar. You can see it will play in this case how I set the length of the grain. Here it's all about grains. So it will play from the beginning up until somewhere here only, from all the 10 seconds we have. And I can scan to different positions of the sample or the recording. And you can already hear also that the panning is also different than in the Morphogene, so here it will randomly pan left or right. And again, this is a mono recording. On the Morphogene it's a stereo recording in this case. And again, here we have only 10 seconds, so this is not the whole recording, the whole loop like I have on the Morphogene. It's just 10 seconds of it. And again, you can see how different they are, just with how you record the sounds into them. Already you can see that they are quite different. And now let's have a look at how we can process also this recording, how they are different in this section. So let's go back to the Morphogene. It will play the whole sample, let's say it's from here until here, and we can change this window size, which is here called the gene size, and make it smaller, so it will play just a sample of the sample. And we can go also really granular on this with the slide. We scan through the sample, and With the morph control, we can bring the next playback earlier than when the playback, the first playback ends, so they will overlap. And in my case, since the last update, you can choose the intervals or how it will react when you turn the morph knob all the way to the right. In my case, it will just play the sample in reverse. Oh yeah. Okay, we can also, of course, change the pitch of this playback of the sample. And here we have colors, so green will be the original playback pitch or rate. We can go up. We can go down. We have colors here to indicate where we are. So for example, white will be one octave down. Yeah. And we can also play this in reverse. Now here we also, on the morphogen, we also have something that's called splices. So we can take this recording, we can take this reel and splice it into smaller sections that will loop just by clicking the splice button. And now I can scan or go between the splices with the organize. And we have the different colors here. So you can actually have, let's say, a few different voices recorded in this almost 3 minutes and splice them. So you have available to you a lot of different options here with the organize. You can just jump between one voice to the other. Or also modulate this, of course. Okay, so this was the morphogen. Let's move now to the arbar. So here again, it's all about grains. We can change the length of the grain. And also here, of course, go really short. We can change the intensity of the grain, so how many grains will be generated. And if I turn on the spray, it will jump between this recording, this sample. You can see also the lights are jumping. I hope you can see this. Yeah, you can see this. Again, change the length of the grains. And you can hear there are many grains, I think 40 grains or something like this. Oh yeah. Now you can also change the shape of the grains, so something from something really snappy. Let's make this smaller. Something really snappy and percussive to something smoother, more smeared maybe. And to just without an attack and decay, something is more square-like envelope. Also here we can change the pitch. And here it's interesting, there is a sort of a sample and hold on this pitch change. So only when the next grain is being fired, only then it will change the pitch. So you can have a sort of polyphony. And we have also sort of a sample and hold to modulate this. So to the right it's more of a stepped signal. All the way it's octaves up and down. To the left it's more smoother modulation. And again, here it's all about generating grains. You can change the intensity or the density, if this sounds familiar, of the grains. You can change their length, you can change their shape. So you see how you get quite different results from the morphogen and quite different results from arbar. So again, this is more of a granular processor than a sampler or a tape machine. Okay, now there are a few other features we can look at. For example, let's go back to the morphogen. On the morphogen, we have a clock input, so we can sync the recording with the clock, and also the clock use the clock to stretch the time of the recording without changing the pitch or the time of the playback. Actually, we have also a CV output, an envelope follower output we can use, and we can of course control the vary speed with CV, and this will also follow 1 volt per octave. We have a gate output, which is a sort of an end of cycle output and will output gates whenever a gene or a splice has ended. We can also trigger the playback with an external trigger. Oh yeah. Okay, and on the arbar, we also have a volt per octave input, so we can control the pitch also with volt per octave. We have also a trigger input for the grains, so I can trigger the grains, or with an external trigger, or manually. We can also scan between the 6 buffers and have on each buffer a different sound and then merge them, sort of fade between them. We also have a gate output. In this case, it will output a signal wherever a grain is being generated. So this is quite different from the morphogen. Here we also have a overdub control, so you can overdub the recordings on the same buffer. And on the arbar, there is also, we can choose to activate a built-in reverb or delay with the jumpers in the back of the module. In my case, I have here reverb, and I can turn it on here. I just have to connect this to the mod input on the expander. There is also an expander for the arbar. Oh yeah. With negative voltage, I can just output the wet signal. Oh yeah! Another Another thing, by the way, that I didn't mention before, and I should have mentioned this, we have also a sort of a Bernoulli gate on the playback direction, forwards or backwards, so I can randomly let the sample play backwards. Which is also quite cool. So you can really see how different they are and how they are actually meant to be used in different ways. Again, the Morphogene is more of a tape machine slash sampler, and Arbar is more of a granular processor. And if you want to compare Arbar to something, it will be Clouds in granular mode. And here I have a Microcell, which is an amazing Clouds clone. from Grayscale. It's a really, really nice module. It has the Parasites firmware and also the Camel. So you have Bit Repeat and you have also Spectral Clouds. But in this case, I will use just the granular mode. So let's take our bar out. I already have the same sample recorded. In this case, I have it set on 8 seconds. So the buffer is 8 seconds long. And now also here we have almost the same controls like the Arbar. We have density, which is here called intensity, to generate the grains. Right, I can scan with the position. I can scan through the sample. I can change the shape. Again, from something smeared to something more percussive and snappy. I can change the size of the grain. Also here there is a panning, randomly panning left and right. And also here I can add some reverb if I want. Create out of a piano, create something totally different. So again, if you want to compare Arbar to something, it will be Clouds in granular mode. And that was it. I really hope I managed to show you that you need both in your system and that they are not really the same type of module. Each one can be used in totally different ways. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button. If you enjoy what I do, consider becoming a Patreon. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe and hit the bell, and have a good one.